Salut les franchises, bienvenue pour cette nouvelle vidéo. Alors oui, ça fait longtemps que j'ai pas posté et je tenais à souhaiter la bienvenue à tous les nouveaux membres de la chaîne Fire Frenchy. Donc comme vous l'aurez deviné aujourd'hui, c'est sur une ambulance. J'ai embrigadé un de mes collègues, Brad, dont c'était le dernier jour au moment où on a enregistré la vidéo, pour qu'il vous présente sa medic unit, comme on appelle ça ici. Et vous allez voir, c'est vraiment très détaillé. Et encore, on n'a pas poussé tout dans le maximum des détails, car ils ont des tablettes et des ordinateurs qu'on n'a même pas abordés pour la vidéo. Mais en tout cas, je vous souhaite un très bon visionnage et je vous retrouve après. Je suis avec mon gars sûr, Brad Waters. Il a accepté
Yeah,
de
man.
faire un tour de l'ambulance. Donc, si vous voulez bien, on va passer à l'arrière. Il va vous montrer de quoi se compose une ambulance paramédique aux États-Unis, tous les composants qu'on y trouve à l'intérieur, tout le matériel médical qu'ils ont, et on lui posera quelques questions ensuite pour savoir de quoi relève sa spécialité.
Good afternoon. Brad Waters, and I'm one of the paramedics here with Harris County ESD Mobile Healthcare. And today we're going to bring you a special edition of EMS. All right, I'd love to show you the mobile hospital we have here and walk you through some of the things, both interior and exterior, that we carry to serve the citizens of our area here in Spring, Texas. All right, so without further ado, let me talk to you about some of the things that we have on this truck that make it special. Okay, so the exterior of this ambulance here has a number of cabinets, and let's walk through them and individually we can talk about what we carry on this ambulance, okay? So inside this cabinet here, you're gonna find our house oxygen tank, and this will support oxygen for several hours for patients that need high flow oxygenation. The brand new ambulance is equipped with a lot of automatic equipment that is ergonomically safer for us. So I'll lift this lever up right here, and we can have this tank slide right on down. This will keep our back safe and allow us to exchange oxygen at a much safer lower on the floor versus being up higher. Move past this cabinet, which contains a lot of the electrical components of the ambulance and keeps things working independently, whether or not the ambulance is running or not, something I can mention to you later. Unique to this cabinet is what we call the piano style accordion fold down, and we'll keep some commonly used items for EMS. You'll see medical gloves here. Because of the COVID pandemic, you'll see masks, cleaning supplies, and disposable linen items that are used frequently on calls that we go on routinely. All right, listen, I love the fire department. Even me, I like to get on Big Red as much as I can. So there's some things that are unique about our ambulance. And you know what? We even try to incorporate some of that fire side into things. So really quickly, this cabinet right here is kind of like a collect-all. We got a little bit of everything in here. We keep our own personal gear. You'll see we keep our own backpacks and such. And down at the bottom here is a cooler. And we use this for hydration. The fire department, sometimes they need that good H2O, that water, keep them hydrated, keep them in their game. So this is super important. And hey, listen, I even got my own fire extinguisher in here, okay? So I can fight fire just like the best of them. Hey, no worries, all right? Okay, we've switched to the opposite side of the ambulance. Let me open this door and explain some of the things we have inside. So over here on the left, this green device here, as well as the yellow one, are commonly used to get people out of tight scenarios and spots, or we can safely bring them to our stretcher, ultimately providing care indoors inside the ambulance. And at the bottom is a unique device as well. It's becoming more of an industry standard for getting people safely up and down stairs and reducing risk of harm to both fire department members and EMS members. Okay, and we're also gonna move to the forward cabinet here, same side of the ambulance. You'll take note that the equipment on the lower portion of this cabinet is reserved for the hybrid ambulance, and it keeps energy and electrical supplies up to top notch, even when the ambulance engine's not running and it's sitting idle like it is now. Up top from above that, you're gonna find some airway management for high acuity patients, a Lucas device, which is good for CPR, and a ventilator towards the back. There's some other nominal equipment up at the top that we can talk about more in detail later. But this is equipment that on the go, we want to be able to access very quickly from the exterior of the ambulance and pull it out rapidly. Oh, all right, we made it indoors. Look, this is the fun part of the ambulance, okay? And this is also where we provide sometimes very acute care that makes a difference in somebody's life. Okay. So welcome to a really top-notch ambulance. These ambulances are extremely durable. We can talk about some technicalities a little bit later, but I do want you to take a look around the ambulance. Everything you're gonna find that we need to take care of the patient is securely stowed. These cabinets right here are all locked and sealed, but they easily are accessible. So at a moment's notice, we can get into each one really quickly. You'll also notice that there's some safety features, things like safety seat belts that we have in here that are essential for us doing our jobs, and it's still providing care to each individual we take care of at a moment's notice. So right in front of us is our medical bag. It's got a complement of a lot of supplies. Let's get into this just really quickly. I'll give you a nice little overview. The benefit of having a bag like this is you can actually wear it on your back like a backpack, and it has straps on the back side of it. On the inside of the bag itself, we have individual compartmentalized items. So you have a medicine bag here. I'll show you just the inside of it briefly. A lot of our paramedic medications we keep in there, as well as equipment to set up and use this medicines. You'll see fluid medications, prepackaged boxing that we have for each of them in different forms, and even just smaller vials yet that even contain medications. Anything from commonality medical problems up to high acuity situations that on a moment's notice we need to administer very. Additional bags that we're gonna keep inside will be a compartment strictly for traumatic injuries with all kinds of dressings, bandages and such to be able to care and modify situations that come up where we need to aggressively take and treat care of patients. We also have pouches that take care of airway management with adjuncts and supplies in each that are all individually packaged, one-time use. I'll open that up a little bit more so just for demo so you can see that in there. This particular package deals strictly with obtaining venous access. We have ways to do that on this ambulance that mean IV administration through the veins, also through use in a bone. And so there's highly specialized equipment and packaging that's all sterile that we can use at a moment's notice to gain that access and ultimately deliver medicines. And finally, we have one final package over here. It's just kind of a catch-all bag. And again, it does provide a lot of airway management for the patients that we encounter. The nice thing is that it's all structured so we can grab this on the go. And when one of these is used in our service, we exchange it out for a brand new one, allowing for very little downtime for use, and we can replenish at a moment's notice. All right, well, I mentioned before that some of the items that we keep here are stowed away in cabinets that are individually packaged. And at the top, we have kits that are comprehensive for things like airway management and for cardiac arrest situations. The next cabinet over there is strictly for behavioral conditions with we need to take care of somebody that's having a mental condition and for trauma injuries. Everything's prepackaged. Any item that we use in there, we can get replenished immediately. We take one bin in and simply swap it for another. The nice thing about these cabinets, if I may really quickly, is not only do they open side to side, but you can unlatch these cabinets and access the whole cabinet itself. I got a little out of order, but if we move right on down towards the end, we have more bins. The bins over here deal with sepsis, things like infection, obstetrical emergencies, and emergencies dealing with allergic reactions. All right, down the bottom below that, you'll see a cabinet that opens up, and in here we have medications that are refrigerated with a cooler. I'm gonna take this bin out, and you can see that. Again, replacement is one for one, and we can get that reused. And right next to it is actually a heater for hot fluid, so we can keep people warm on cool evenings or when they're facing emergencies that deal with temperature variants. I want to share with you quickly about this cabinet. Something very unique that we have here is a system called Hand Tevi. This bag is uniquely designed to take care of pediatric patients at large. And individual zippered pouches, we carry different pieces of equipment. All are available for kids anywhere from infancy all the way up to the teenage years. You'll find everything comprehensively labeled and put in pouches. So they're easily and readily accessible. And probably the neatest part about this compartment in the middle are pouches that are designed to accommodate age-specific issues. And you'll see here, anywhere from under 1 year of age all the way up to 13. Now they're all labeled and they're all sealed. So when I open one up, every piece of equipment caters to the individual of that size and age. Airway management tools are also included here, and an assortment compartment here of medical and trauma issues that we can manage right underneath there. It's a great piece we have here. I'm glad we have it on our truck. All right, one of the pieces of equipment we have here is for ventilation of patients. As people get age, as they age and they're having more troubles with their respiratory components, we actually have an assistive device here now that I'll show the inside of it, that you use and set up so that it automatically will breathe up for them. This is a great piece of equipment, a tool that is needed in dire situations and can really make an impact on someone's life. Disposable equipment's down at the bottom, and some pouches with varying airway management equipment that will connect into this device. Once this device is powered on, forgive me, a display will come up here with assortment of buttons that we can cater and customize to treat patients. Both patients that have advanced airway tubing inside of them, and also patients who just may need a little bit of supportive breathing until we can get to the hospital. A fantastic piece of equipment we have, invaluable, and let me tell you, this is top notch. As you go by industry standards, this hits it wholeheartedly. Well, a lot of services are going to this machine that you see right in front of you. This is called the Lucas device. It's used worldwide right now. It's gained a lot of notoriety because, in essence, it takes the position of 1 to 2 emergency personnel, placing it on a machine to render cardiopulmonary resuscitation. It's acting like a plunger to actually squeeze the heart when the heart has stopped working. This backpack configuration is pretty nice, but as we open it up, you'll see that there's a backrest plate in here, the device itself, which actually latches onto the back plate, and then a piston once the machine's turned on that can actually compress the heart at a rate of about 100 to 125 beats every minute. And some ancillary equipment in here, like neck strap to keep the machine safe for them. Extra batteries lie in here, as well as charging equipment should this piece of device be needed for long extended periods of time. A fantastic piece of advice. I really like it. I think every emergency personnel apparatus needs to have one of these on here, and they're moving in that direction. A lot of ambulances will have this area that they call an action area. It's just a good, nice space that we have. It affords an opportunity to render care for somebody on a flat surface. But over here, what's unique is we do have the airway management suction, a device that when you turn on, can draw power and essentially remove foreign objects from somebody's mouth. Adjacent to are two oxygen hookups that support oxygen through the oxygen tank that we talked about earlier on the exterior of the ambulance. And then various light switches. So we have low and high dim switches for lights. We also have a little overhead light here too. A vent for exhausting all the air that we have to the exterior side of the ambulance. A light over here. And then again, just more pump and vacuum pressure on here. One thing that I really like about the truck too, with all this electrical equipment, is they've come up with the USB ports. Kind of more an industry standard here, right? And 12 volt capacity, so that we can plug in a lot of devices simultaneously and be self-supported. Well, now we're at the back of the ambulance. Let me open up the inside and show you how we can get our stretcher from outside for use here at the ground level. This is our Power Pro auto load stretcher. If you notice, the ambulance actually lowered, making it easier for us to get out. A simple one push of a button and a pull, simple as one hand, will slide and guide us right on out. And with the stretcher's locked, one touch button with one finger gets the safety on the ground. These are great. I'd say, how do we ever do things without them before, right? I'll unlock that and pull them right away. And so this carriage system's designed to be able to just repeat that process to get the patient right back in. Stryker Pro Stretcher with all the equipment comes to us on every medical call that we have. Our cardiac monitor here, top notch. The bag that I went over earlier for you, and then some fun stuff with the stretcher, so we can get a patient seated all the way up, right? We can lower the height of the stretcher down, battery operated, any level, so we can easily have somebody walk and sit on it any time. Nice features about this too is it's completely movable with the wheels that we have on there. You'll see a number of security straps we put on place to keep people safe and load them in the back of the ambulance. I love this piece of equipment. I'd say the most commonly used item is this right here by far, and this acts as sort of a third personnel, but the paramedic, the EMT, and the stretcher need to be on every call that we go on. So you'll notice I'm going to go ahead and put the stretcher back in here. Again, this is one touch operation. The button itself just acts to raise and lower the stretcher. And we'll bring this right around here. We can load this stretcher into the ambulance by docking it to the back system we have in place. Green lights indicate towards the back that this is ready and safe to be able to load up. And this just picks this right on up. Rated for around 700 pounds here in the US. Slide it right onto the back of the ambulance, where it locks in place, a battery indicator light to make sure that the unit is fully charged and ready for operational use. Love it. EMS at its finest, ladies and gentlemen. That's the house we serve right here for spring, 410. Don't forget it. Okay, well, hey, listen, I mentioned that at our service here, any of the equipment right here that's disposable, we can replenish. So this particular bin right here has been opened with items that are used. And just so happened that our supply guy came here while I was talking. So we're gonna walk out here. I'll take this whole bin, hand it to him, and then just exchange for a brand new one that I can easily put back in the ambulance. The benefit to a system like this, it minimizes any downtime and service disruption needs we have. So I'll simply come in here, leave the bin at his disposal, and then he has a bin right up here that I can get extra supplies in. Let me step aside real quick so you guys can take a quick look at the number of items that our service can readily stock and have available. These vans operate 24 hours a day. And they can come to any of the individual stations that we have and bring supplies out, as well as meet us on emergency scenes or at hospitals so we can keep supplying all ambulances at a moment's notice.
Alors nous voici à l'arrière de l'ambulance. On va se faire une petite interview avec mon ami Brad Waters. Donc je vais lui poser quelques questions sur le métier de paramédic. Et Brad, je voulais te demander, quelles sont certaines spécialités que les EMT paramedics peuvent faire en intervention?
Sure, great. So, good question. So, you'll notice right here is a cardiac monitor. So, we have advanced cardiac monitoring we can put in place, something we routinely do, but does require the training that we have in order to be able to interpret that information. The bag right here supplies everything from medical to trauma at a moment's notice. Now, there are some specialized things that you had asked about. So, things like decompressing needles that would alleviate air and inside of chest wall cavity that could be life-threatening. The medicine that we talked about earlier, some of that cardiac medicine is life and death changing. So it's immediate stuff that we have to have available at a moment's notice. So there's some high-tech stuff that we have available in here. Some of it also is in the cafeteria around here. And then simple things like even the oxygen and things like that we carry that are readily available.
Yeah. Okay, Brad, si tu veux nous expliquer un peu ton passé, comment est-ce que tu es rentré dans le monde des EMT? Quelle est ton expérience? Combien d'années de métier est-ce que tu as?
Oh yeah, brother, of course. So, here I am at 45 years of age, and I can tell you I've been doing this about 22 years, and I really got a love and passion for it. My roots start back outside the state of Texas, where I was born and raised in California. I grew up in Los Angeles, and that really got my feet wet into it just out of my high school years. And I got immersed into EMS, really enjoyed the passion of helping others. And then about 8 or 10 years ago, I moved out to Texas. And I feel like this is home for me right now. You know, I like the fire department interaction that I have here with Franchi and a number of other guys at the firehouse, and the camaraderie that's built, also the passion and love that I have for serving the community. This top-notch equipment right here, it's only possible because of the citizens that we service, the tax base that we have and things like that. So, you know, this is a great job. I can't see really doing much else, anything different. It's something I stuck with and it's my passion. I hope that, you know, pretty soon I'll be able to actually retire from this job, look back and say, hey, this was great. But these fire guys right here and us,
I mean,
it's great, man. You know, that's how we got to do it right here. Hey, but it's all with fun and heart, yeah. So glad I can answer the question for you on that.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Uh-huh.
Okay, brother. Merci beaucoup.
Oh, brother. Of course, man.
Merci beaucoup.
Hey, this is the guy right here, okay? This is the guy.
Il a pris
son temps,
ça a pris plusieurs heures rien pour enregistrer ça, et puis quand même assez froid dehors, donc un grand merci à Brad Waters, n'hésitez pas à mettre un pouce en l'air, un like, un commentaire pour le remercier sur la vidéo, et moi je vous retrouve la prochaine fois.
Et voilà, j'espère que cette vidéo vous aura plu. Alors je tiens encore une fois à remercier Brad Waters, qui est mon ancien collègue qui travaillait ici avec nous à Station 73 avant, maintenant il est parti dans une autre caserne un peu plus près de chez lui, et je tiens aussi bien évidemment à remercier ESD 11 de nous avoir laissé la liberté d'enregistrer une de leurs ambulances pour vous la présenter à vous. Et j'espère que d'ici peu, je pourrai reposter plein de vidéos. J'ai d'énormes projets à venir, notamment avec d'autres ambulances, dans d'autres services incendie, avec des collègues avec qui j'ai parlé. Éventuellement, on va s'aventurer du côté police. J'aimerais vraiment pouvoir explorer le SWAT et les choses comme ça. Donc abonnez-vous en masse, mettez des pouces en l'air. Suivez les vidéos, suivez-moi sur Instagram, FireFrenchy73. N'oubliez surtout pas d'aller consulter le site de rescue18.fr car il est vraiment super intéressant. Et je vous retrouve la prochaine fois.